Hello, this is Esin from IBCS, and today we're going to talk about implementing IBCS rules with SAP Analytics Cloud. International Business Communication Standards, or IBCS in short, is a common notation for business reporting, like as in the notes for music or maps in navigation. We are proposing standard notation, standard visualization for business reporting. For example, every solid bar is for actuals, outlined for budgets, and hatched for forecasts. Similarly, every green shows something positive when every red shows something negative for us. Every graph starts from zero. Every element is as simple as possible. Applicable to finance, human resources, sustainability reporting, valid for every domain. That way, every report is easy to grasp, comparable to different scenarios, and clearly defined. To create good and solid reports, we need software. And IBCS compliant reports can be created with several software and add-ons. You can reach the most recent list of softwares on our website. We are excited to announce that we now offer the IBCS Certified Analyst in-house training with the option to use your IBCS compliant software of choice. This unique approach not only helps you grasp the IBCS concepts, but also provides hands-on experience on your software. Today, we're going to talk about SAP Analytics Cloud, which is one of them. Lots of companies use SAP Analytics Cloud to implement IBCS-inspired or IBCS-compliant reports. Let's look at several examples of them. Our first example is from media sector. G&J is one of Europe's largest magazine publishing companies. It has about 500 magazines, digital products, and services. With Blue Forte, G&J has developed a reporting tool, G&J Compass, and it has been implemented on SAP Analytics Cloud. Compass enabled analysts from various business units to step into a constructive dialogue about trends and critical developments, thus facilitating a new culture of data-driven decision-making. Here is one of their reports. This page is prepared for analyzing the advertisement revenues and advertisement pages of two different magazines. In the timeline, the months are laid in X-axis. The budget values are outlined and the actuals are solid. Green for positive variances and red for negative variances. The first two graphs represent absolute values, and the final one is the ratio of them. Left side lines and signs show the calculation methodology. A very IBCS-like design, right? And here is another example. A waterfall chart created in SAP Analytics Cloud. It's a contribution analysis of a magazine revenues and costs. Revenue items, total revenue, costs. The first column shows the actuals. We also have budget and variances. So like IBCS too. As we understand, reports achieved a high level of user acceptance. Carsten Weiss expressed his opinion as,
"With Blue Forte's support, we developed modern user-centric dashboards and planning masks. Thanks to the uniform user interface, carefully selected content, and easy-to-understand IBCS-compliant visualizations, users notice the added value quickly."
We are very happy to hear that. And here is another example, this time created with Windhoff Group. Company is OpenGrid, Europe's leading gas transmission system operator. OpenGrid examples are from cost variance analysis report. Here, each line represents a customer in a descending order of actual values of transported energy. The actual values are compared with previous years, customer by customer. The absolute and percentage variances are shown as in-cell charts. It is quite easy to organize such an IBCS compliant table in SAP Analytics Cloud. Here is another example for small multiples, which is a characteristic visualization for IBCS and easy to implement on SAP Analytics Cloud. We have a small graph for every customer on the same scale. So it's easy to see every company in its own timeline as well as compared to other customers. The last example we have is developed with Plus IT, and the company is Acceleron Industries, a global leader in high-power turbocharging and digital solutions. Acceleron examples are profitability-related. On this first page, we have an overview of top four profitability KPIs compared to previous years and budget figures. And on the second page, we have top 15 KPIs. Table is designed with clear grouping and formatting. Each column has corresponding decorative line, and relative variances are shown as in cell pin charts. A nicely prepared IBCS-inspired report. It's great to show real-life examples, so thank you very much for sharing. And if you are also using SAP Analytics Cloud, I strongly recommend you to check IBCS compliant features. They are being extended with new releases. That's why maybe we can go through a few of them together. First, visualizing the variances on top of a graph is very helpful. And with the new release, we now have further fine-tuning. Firstly, the previous color palette was not exactly the IBCS recommendation. Now it's possible to change the colors. Secondly, the number formatting options are extended to include K for thousands and M for million and BN for billion, just like IBCS recommendations. Moreover, the currency acronyms can be shown according to ISO standard three-letter representation, which is again an IBCS recommendation. Thirdly, the waterfall variance representation is introduced. With just one graph, we both see the monthly changes and cumulated variance, which is a very nice condensed and informative representation. I also want to show you ranking feature. Rank with others is a new and handy feature. Let me put the use case of this graph like this. Sometimes we have a long list of values on the data, but in the graph, we are only interested in the top values, such as top 10 or top 5. And put the rest in just one bin of others. This is a recommendation of IBCS to focus on the important figures but keep the rest on the graph for being collectively exhaustive. Sorting is the last feature that I want to explore with you. SAP Analytics Cloud can do sorting, of course, for such a long time. But now it's also possible to sort on variances and percentage variances. Sometimes it is more interesting to see the changes. And that's why we are focusing on the variances way more than the absolute values. That's why it's important to have this type of flexibility while we are making our sorting. After seeing a few SAP Analytics Cloud features, now we are reaching the end of this video. Lastly, I want to remind you that we have an SAP Analytics Cloud flavored version of IBCS Certified Analyst course. Actually, I personally give this training. We recommend this training to business teams who are already familiar with SAP Analytics Cloud. While the workshop, participants learn IBCS approaches and rules and apply them on the exercises created on top of SAP Analytics Cloud. We have conducted this training for business users, SAP Analytics Cloud developers, and SAP Analytics Cloud consultants. If you are also interested in such training, please feel free to reach us. I hope that this video gives you an idea about SAP Analytics Cloud and how to use it on IBCS compliant reporting. Take care.